We want to plot the given point on the coordinate plane below. Point D has coordinates negative 2/3, comma negative 2.5. This indicates x equals negative 2/3 and y equals negative 2.5. Let's begin by locating negative 2/3 on the x-axis and negative 2.5 on the y-axis. To locate negative 2/3 on the x-axis, we'll break the interval from 0 to negative 1 into 3 equal parts, so we can count by negative 1/3. Starting at x equals 0, we have x equals negative 1/3, x equals negative 2/3. Next would be x equals negative 3/3, which is equal to negative 1. And now let's locate negative 2.5 on the y-axis, which is right in the middle between negative 2 and negative 3, we'll say here. And now to plot point D from the origin, because x is negative 2/3, we move left 2/3 units. And then because y is negative 2, we go down 2.5 units. This is the location of point A. Point E has coordinates 2.5, comma 0. Because x equals 2.5, let's locate 2.5 on the x-axis, which is right between positive 2 and positive 3. And now to plot point E, because x is 2.5 from the origin, we move 2.5 units to the right. Because y is 0, we do not move up or down. Point E is this point here on the x-axis. Point F has coordinates of 0, comma, negative 3/2. Let's begin by locating negative 3/2 on the y-axis. Negative 3/2 equals negative 1.5. But if we don't recognize this, we'll break the interval from 0 to negative 2 on the y-axis into intervals of width 1/2. We'll put a tick mark here and a tick mark here. And now we can count by negative 1/2. So we have negative 1/2, negative 2/2, or negative 1, and then negative 3/2. Negative 4/2 is equal to negative 2. And again, we can see now negative 3/2 is equivalent to negative 1.5. To plot point F from the origin, because x is 0, we do not move left or right. And because y is negative 3/2 or negative 1.5, we move down 3/2 units, or down 1.5 units to negative 3/2. Notice point F is on the y-axis. I hope you found this helpful.